Hey everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Today I'm going to be playing Halo 5's Warzone Firefight mode, which I'm a big fan of. As you may know, I'm kind of a horde mode person. I like playing the games where it's co-op and you've got the waves and waves of enemies coming at you. This is the Halo version of that, if you're not familiar with it. It's 8 players. And you've got to complete 5 waves of objectives. You've got to usually it's almost always you know, kill this or find this other thing and kill it. Actually, there's no almost always about it. It just straight up is always kill this thing to continue. But it's a good time. It's fun, and 8-player co-op. That's hard to come by these days. So, but anyway. Looks like it's loading me into a match here. And this is actually a map I'm not familiar with at all for this mode. I've not played on this map yet. For Firefight, anyway. Regular Warzone, sure, but not Firefight. So if you look in the lower right corner right now, that's our objective, and it looks like we've just got to kill 60 grunts, and we're at 24 down so far.
Hit. Return fire.
Now these are basically just these big. Ooh, forgot I can't. forgot I couldn't double jump there. Wrong game. I was just playing Titanfall the other day, so I think maybe that's still fresh on the brain. But anyway, the versus mode, Warzone, this is that, just without the versus part. It's you and 7 teammates on those same maps fighting the AI. And you've got a limited amount of time to complete all these objectives. So again, the lower right corner there, we're at 35 out of our 60 grunts that we need to take down. And we've got 2.5 minutes left to finish them off, it would seem. Oh. Wow, I'm surprised I made it through that. Oh. Whew, I love Halo. I'm a longtime fan. I actually bought an Xbox, an OG original Xbox back in like, what, 2001, I guess, maybe was that, or maybe it was 2002, I can't remember exactly. Whatever year the Xbox came out, that was the winter that I got one, and I got it just for Halo. I remember reading the reviews in EGM, among a lot of other magazines at the time, and that's what sold me on it. They were talking about how you were going through these levels, and you always had AI soldiers rolling along with you in your vehicles and stuff, and they're saying, like, yeah, you know, there's all these times when you just feel like you're really a part of a bigger war effort here with all of the AI teammates that they give you. And I just thought, wow, that sounds awesome. So I got that, and I've been a Halo fan ever since. And, you know, I haven't always loved everything that Halo has done. But Halo 5, I think, is a pretty solid game all around. I don't really do the versus stuff just because I'm not good enough at it. People are just savage at these games, right? I mean, this and Call of Duty and stuff. I don't play really most shooters competitively just because people are just absolutely bonkers good at this stuff. And I can't keep up, man. I play a lot of... I guess I kind of play a variety of games, and I don't usually stick with any one shooter for that long, with the exception being stuff that has like these co-op modes, like Gears of War. I was really into for a long time. Gears of War 3 in particular. Spent a lot of time playing the co-op horde mode there. Man, look at all these little turds around here. I gotta clear them out before I can go for the big dogs. The big dogs are just kind of standing there, though, begging to be shot. I can't help myself. Well, that was a crap grenade throw right there. Well, the upside of dying here is now that I can access my Rex and see if maybe I can get a better weapon. Actually, I don't love any of the stuff that I've got available right now. I'm gonna just wait. But anyway, back to the history, or my history rather, with Halo. I was obsessed with Halo 1 when I got it. I thought it was just remarkable all around. I loved the smart AI of the enemies. I loved the feeling of rolling with your fellow soldiers and stuff and fighting the scary Covenant. You know, they didn't speak English yet, really. I mean, the grunts did, but they were a lot more mysterious in that first game. And they just seemed like this threat that was hell-bent on wiping out humanity. And fighting against something like that is something that's easy for me to get behind, right? And then, like, the feeling of just kind of the solitude, the loneliness in some of the levels, like Assault on the Control Room, for example. It has moments where you are with your fellow soldiers and stuff, but there's also a lot of moments where you're alone. And I always thought that those were really cool... really cool levels, really cool moments, too, just because you can kind of approach things on your terms. The game gave you a lot of freedom, which wasn't as common back then. We didn't have so many open-world games, and it wasn't that... I know Halo wasn't an open-world game, but the way that you could approach some of the levels almost felt like it. This was before we had, like, you know, a Far Cry every couple of years, and... five Grand Theft Auto games and all that, you know, so. Oh man, I need to get in that building. I don't want to be out here. This is a mess. Get some cover.
Throwing grenade! Soldiers got me in his sights!
Whew. It's getting intense now. Oh, man. I felt like that came out of nowhere. Oh, sweet. Now I can do my battle rifle. Yeah, I like the hybrid. There we go. So anyway, with Halo, I've played all of them. I've read some of the novels. Back when the first game was out and before Halo 2 came out, they had three novels. There was Halo, The Fall of Reach. Gosh, what was it? I can't remember what the other two were called. I just remember the first one was The Fall of Reach. I read all three of those. Was way into it. Just, you know, anything Halo, I was all over it. Halo 2 came out. I was kind of disappointed. I didn't love that you played as the Covenant or the Arbiter. I didn't like that the elites suddenly spoke English and there were the other races that spoke English. They were much more mysterious and more threatening and menacing when you didn't know what their motivations were. Giving them a language kind of humanized them in a way that I didn't really care for. And also, I just felt like the game was kind of... Oh man, I don't want to face that guy with just a pistol. That's why. also, I just thought the game was a little... I don't know, it felt like the dev team got a little big for their britches. I don't know how to really articulate that beyond, like, pointing at the soundtrack and saying, like, you know... They thought it was important to have, like, Breaking Benjamin and Incubus and stuff in the soundtrack, which isn't the end of the world or anything, but it's... That wasn't what made Halo for me, you know? I think, looking back, that was kind of like their rock star moment, you know, where they're like, we're so big, we've got, like, the biggest game for Microsoft, and it's gonna be huge, and now, yeah, let's get our favorite bands and stuff on the soundtrack. Like, I don't blame them. If I could make whatever game I wanted to, and I thought I was hot shit, I would get Symphony X to do the soundtrack. So I can understand. But Halo 2 is kind of a mixed bag. The multiplayer, though, I mean, man, I can't hate on that at all. I spent hours and hours playing the multiplayer. It was mostly just the campaign that I had my beefs with. Same thing with Halo 3. Halo 3, really great. Four-player campaign, that was awesome. But I didn't love some of the direction that they took the story. I didn't like the levels where you were chasing after Cortana, and she was just kind of spouting gibberish intermittently and slowing down the action and all that. Those levels were a slog. Let's see. Then there was Halo ODST, which I liked quite a bit, aside from the I thought the writing was kind of bad. I didn't like the love story angle between Buck and... I can't remember the gal's name. I thought their love story just seemed... I mean, it was fine. You can have them be a couple, but they land in a hot war zone, right? And there's bullets flying everywhere and people going down and stuff, and they're bickering about, like, couple shit, you know? It's just kind of like... I think they would put that aside. With, you know, they're supposed to be, like, the elite-level soldiers that we have. I think they would probably stop bickering long enough to fight whatever battle they're in, and then maybe pick that up afterward. But I guess maybe that doesn't bring the drama like the dev team or the writers were hoping for. I don't know. Let's see. What else was after ODST? I think there was Halo Reach, which I was a big fan of. Really, really like Halo Reach a lot. That's probably my second favorite Halo game. Just because I like the characters, I like the story a lot. I love the ending. The ending's beautiful. So bittersweet. Really like the firefight mode in that game. I know ODST was the start of firefight mode, and I didn't acknowledge that a second ago. But I liked what Reach did with it. It took it up a level, basically. And then you got Halo 4, which... I liked the campaign, aside from where they took the story. It was kind of hard to follow what was happening. I don't know, man. Like, the people that stayed on from Bungie when this turned over to 343 Studios, because Bungie left and Microsoft basically bought this series, or owned it already. I'm not sure the timeline exactly, but this was... Halo was Microsoft's, right? And anybody who wanted to work on Halo had to leave Bungie and stay behind and work for 343. And I feel sometimes like the people at 343 get caught up in the gobbledygook that Halo is kind of bogged down with, in my opinion. Like, all this stuff about, like, Didax and Reclaimers and all this, like, I don't know what they're talking about, and I've played all of these games, you know? Like, it's really easy for me to kind of lose track of where the story's going. In Halo 5, too, here. And that's just kind of a weird situation, considering that I haven't missed a Halo game yet. So, and I haven't, you know, granted, I don't read the, I don't read the extra stuff in the universe, you know, like all the comics and extra novels that they've done. And I guess some people would make the argument that, well, that's why you don't know what's going on. You gotta read all this extra shit. That's fine if you're that person, but I feel like the games need to be able to stand on their own. And they can't count on people having read all that stuff, you know? So... that's just my opinion on it, though, but... Anyway, that brings us to Halo 5 now, which I really like. I didn't always know what was happening in the story, and I kind of wish that that wasn't the case, but it's beautiful. I really like this game. I think the... I don't play the multiplayer. I can't speak at all as to the map design for, like, 4v4, classic Halo kind of stuff. So I don't know about that. I haven't been into that since Halo 3. Or actually since Reach. That's more accurate. But what I have played here, the campaign and the firefight mode, I really dig it. I think it's great. I think it plays great, it's smooth, and it's classic Halo. Like, that's what this mode is for me, this firefight mode in particular. This is everything that is Halo. You know, you're fighting the Covenant, you're fighting the Prometheans here. You've got access to all these different weapons. It's just constant firefights, right? It's kind of like the best of the action that this series has to offer, and that's why I love it. Round complete. So I'm going to get out a rare random weapon for funsies because I can. Let's see, what did I get? Hey, a rocket launcher! Alright. Yeah, if you're not familiar with this, the way that the weapons work here is you've got a handful of weapons that you can have as your starting weapons, and then all the other weapons that you want to use, you earn these kind of one-time use cards, basically, in order to get access to the other weapons. I really want to take down that ship. Can't do it. Out of ammo.
That's a headshot.
And so that's what I was doing anyway. I was accessing my cards and picking a random rare weapon was what I went for. You can be more specific than that, right? But they've got a spot here, random weapons, and that's what I went with. So I think I'm going to go with fuel rod cannon because I want something a little powerful here. And we are on the final round here, so it's going to be tough bosses here, and that's why I wanted to get out the power weapons. What I should do next is get out a vehicle, really. Now that I'm on the final round here, it's all about bringing out your best vehicles.
Teammates eliminated the Elite Prime.
Oh, but we're going inside, actually, so now vehicles are going to be mostly useless. Like this tank, he's not going to have an angle at the enemies in here. The Wraith up ahead, he might be able to get some mortars lobbed in there, but I don't know. Oh, crap. I knew it was a gamble trying to switch weapons right there. Too many enemies around. And actually, let's swap out my pistol with the DMR, because I like that weapon a lot. I've got a gun goose. I'm going to... No, I don't think I can get him up there, actually. There's no stairway. There's no stairway for me to use, so it's all about power weapons right now.
Hit him!
We'll try a plasma caster instead of my DMR.
Two minutes remain.
So you can see I've got those four enemies marked on the screen in red with the skulls next to them. Those are our targets. Good. Oh wow, Grunt with an overshield. Fairly uncommon. Ooh, hunters. Missed. Got him, that'll help. Fried my teammate there.
1 minute left.
1 minute left, and we got three of them to kill? Oh man, I don't know if we're gonna make this. I don't think we're going to. Yeah, and I just got totally dusted there. I'm gonna get back into it with almost no time left. I won't even make it back to the enemy. Respawn counter is so long at this point. It's a lot shorter in the earlier rounds, but yeah. I think we're gonna fail this one.
Seconds.
Oh yeah, full health bar pretty much up there. We're done.
Objective failed.
Oh well. We gave it a good effort there. That one's tough. That area, and I said incorrectly at the beginning, I haven't played this map before. I totally have played that map. I remember it now. It just seemed unfamiliar at first. I don't know that I've played the snow variant of it, but definitely had that area at the end where the hunters have been kind of back in that base and you can't get vehicles back there, which makes it a lot harder. All right, so it looks like in about 25 seconds we'll have our next go at it. The thing about this game that troubles me a little bit is I don't know if this mode's going to work when the servers are gone. Like, I don't know if Halo 5 is going to work at all. Maybe the campaign will, but I really like Firefight mode. I would love it if you could play this mode offline in like a LAN party or something like that, you know? Something where you could connect some a few Xbox Ones. Get like 4 to 8 of them connected at like a convention, like your PAX, your Midwest Gaming Classic, that kind of thing. And have them all connected and have people playing and having a good time. And I feel like a lot of developers overlook that and just go with the online only, and that's too bad. I mean, in years from now, right, like I might want to revisit this, and it'll be kind of a shame if I can't. I can go back and play Reach anytime. I can play Reach Firefight mode offline. So why not this one, you know? But I don't think that's how it works. I don't know. I'll have to test that out, but I'm fairly certain that this is online only.
Suit up, Spartans. This is Warzone Firefight. You're the last boots on the ground. Fight through rounds of increasing difficulty.
Oh, and there's no music in this mode. Because I've shut it off. I've got my own personal background music playing.
Round one.
I've got a nice heavy metal playlist going, of course. You know me. And so now all you hear is the sound effects, I'm sure, on the broadcast, because the music doesn't come across. It's playing in the simple background music player app, and that doesn't come through in the broadcast. Which is just as well, honestly, because if it did, they would just mute the archive of this, and I'd never be able to get it on YouTube. At least not without any sound. Or not with any sound, rather. Can't think and die at the same time here. I like this mode, though, because it almost feels like you're doing a raid in an MMO or in even Destiny kind of thing, right? Because you're not just hunkering down in one spot and waiting for them to come to you. Usually, they'll spawn all over the map, and you'll kind of have to go get them. I'm going to die. Oh, I'm really lucky there. Thought for sure I was done. There we go.
Picked up the sword.
Heavy burnt out.
That's a shame. That guy stole my sword too. That was my elite kill. Oh well.
Elite takedown. Level 2 wrecks available. Round complete.
I don't think I can change my layout yet here. Yeah, no. I guess battle rifle must be level 3. You can see in the upper left corner my rec level. We're only at 2 right now. And some of your loadout, like your starting loadout weapons, you can change, but you've just got to wait until you get to a higher rec level than what you start at. And then you'll just spawn with them every time. Unlike the ones where you burn up a card to use it, those you just have until you die. And then they're gone. Unless you can get back to your corpse and pick it up again, but odds are probably against that, just because other people will pick it up, or so much is happening that that they'll just disappear. Oh my god, there we go. Couldn't put that guy down. Ha! Warthog just bulldozed right over that guy. Ammo refill. Oh god, I gotta get in the building. That airship just raining bombs on me out there. I think it was that one. Yep. Oh, I'm gonna eat it if I'm not careful. Those little bastards with their fuel rod cannons out there.
Phantom takedown. Level 3 wrecks available. Round complete.
Wow. Alright, let's see. Ah, hey, there we go. Now I can get my battle rifle out.
Red confirmed.
And this is a good map for a vehicle, but I'm gonna wait until I can get something that flies. Just cause the area around our building here looks a little tight. And there's a couple of hogs out there already.
Grunt mech near your position.
Maybe I'll go be a gunner for this guy. Cause why not?
Shields are full.
Not like I have a great weapon or anything that I'm trying not to get killed with. Oh, so the grunt mech, I love this guy, he's new. They just added him to this mode like a month ago. He's a fun new boss. Come on, driver, get us out of here. Whew. We're lucky. Lucky we lived through that. Because that was tight. Oh, crap. Totally ran over our teammate.
Got a grunt targeting. Enemy ghost bearing down.
Gun overheated there. I think I'm going down here any minute, any second. Wow. I can't believe we lived through all that. That was quite the shitstorm. Oh no, oh no! Get us out of here, driver!
Shields are back.
Down there. That was a heck of a run, though. That was not too bad in the Warthog. Wonder if I've got just enough time to turn my music up a little bit louder. Alright, here we go. I like it loud. Oh, why does he aim for me, man? I'm just a nobody. I'm on foot, and I just spawned. Nice.
Round complete.
Look up fuel rod cannon.
Always feels great taking down the bosses. Especially when like the whole team is here and you've just got one enemy that's just kind of getting everybody's attention at one time. Ammo up here.
Round four.
All right. What have I got here?
Incoming Prometheans.
I really want to burn some fun weapons here. I kind of want to wait for a vehicle, though. I'm going to do that. I'll just wait. I'll hang tight.
Multiple Phaetons in the air.
Oh, no, I'm not. Phaetons need turrets.
Red confirmed.
Phaetons are, I think, kind of a pain to deal with. If you don't have, like, some kind of chain gun, some kind of good rapid-fire weapon that you can just hold the reticle on them and just keep it going for a while, watch that life bar tick down. If you don't have something like that, they just take forever to put down. All right, he's kind of far away, but I think I can hit him. Yeah, he's coming to me now. Awesome. Got his full attention. And I got nowhere to go. Wow, that thing just disappeared, and that wasn't from me. So watch that life bar there. Just ticked down so nicely with that weapon. Anything yet? Random vehicle. I could try that. Oh, a rare random vehicle. Yeah, I'll go with that. It's gonna be something good, whatever it is. Oh, hey, a rocket hog. I'm down with that. That could be cool. What I need to do is pick up somebody. Let's see if Neat will hop in here. Oh, nope. He's got his own tank. Okay, I don't blame you. Hey, here we go. This guy might be able to. He's sitting there messing with his wrecks. Yeah, come on, jump in. Yes, my man. Or woman, I don't know what you are, but it doesn't matter. I'm just happy you're on the guns. Yes. Oh, crap. Yeah, let's turn around. Let's get out of that mess.
Six wrecks available. Two targets remain. Direct hit.
Nice, we are laying waste with this thing.
Target wounded.
Things that we're supposed to be protecting, though, they are taking kind of a beating. I know, here we go. There's a vantage point up there. Let's get my boy up here. How's that? Oh, no, 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 no. I don't want to fall off. There we go. He's doing it. Ah, this is the spot right here. Uh-oh. I hope those guys don't drop bombs. Look to our right. Look to our right. Yes. Watch those banshees, dude. Get you out of here. Come back. We'll go back.
Got an elite.
Look to the left. Look to the left. Working out. Doing work.
I'm hit.
Man, where am
Enemy
I getting
fire.
Hit from?
Enemy elite firing on me. I'm hit. Return fire on that elite.
Just fire into the mass of meat over there. Nice. This is fantastic.
Simulation complete.
Look at that.
Level 7 wrecks available.
That Rocket Hog just crushed it up there on that vantage point. I love it. I bet the guy on the gun loved it too. I made his night. I made his game. It's like, hey, here's a great weapon and a great vantage point to use it from, and I'll get you out of trouble when you're in it. Good times. Oh, looks like I've got some of those rec packs that have the burn cards in them. So yeah, this is a rare weapon that I've got, or that I've earned now, or unlocked. Gosh, I can't think and talk and look at all this crap at the same time. This is another, obviously, ultra-rare version of a weapon that you could get a hold of, more random stuff, right? This is a nicer pack. This is a gold pack, so there should be better stuff in this one, and more of it. So I got certified to drive a Wraith. Along with some cards to use to actually summon a Wraith. And this is this Wild Hunt. This is a visor for my guy, but I'm pretty happy with the one I've got on there, so I'm going to leave it. Some more stuff for customization, like your player card stuff. More weapons and things like that I can earn. These are all cards that basically I'll burn when I want to use these things. So there's that. Oh, and I got one more here. Game's about to start. Yeah, okay, got it. Didn't have time to open that other rec pack, so that's fine.
Welcome to Warzone, Spartan. You're the last boots on the ground.
Thank you.
Fight through rounds of increasing difficulty.
Oh man, Fear Factory's body hammer is just getting underway here as this loads up.
Spartan.
So perfect. I can't imagine not listening to metal when I play games like this. Like, if you're not a heavy metal fan, what music do you listen to when you play games like this? I mean, I guess you just listen to the game's music, right? But, I don't know, it's so much more awesome with some good metal in the background. Oh, Andrew, shut up. We all know you love your metal. All right, fair enough. So I guess I gotta go back outside to get over to that spot or something. There was probably another way and I just missed it. Guys on me, wouldn't you know it? Wow, they ran up fast. Nope, I guess I don't have anything really to use just yet. Man, when you have a pack of the basic enemies like that and they all fire on you at once, it can actually put you down fairly quickly.
Taking
Yeah, it's rough. It can be rough. Look at all those enemies there. Wow. They're storming that place. There's got to be a leap pad around here to jump me back over there quickly. I guess there's not.
2 minutes remain.
Oh, I've had enough of you guys.
Only a couple targets left.
Seriously. Doing terrible this game. Oh, woof.
Base defended. Round complete.
Soldiers got me in a fire.
Level 2 wrecks available.
Can I pick that up from up here? No. Not really.
Time are increased. Incoming.
Bet I can get up there again from here. Nope. Not with that thing.
Promethean threat materializing.
There we go. All that work to get up here, and now my enemies are way over there. It's like, what are you doing? What are you even doing? I don't know. Nice. Okay, let's take a minute, let the shield recharge. Oh, you.
We're losing teammates to the Prometheans.
Oh! It's what happens when you don't sit and take the time to let your shield recharge. Keep peeking out. I feel like it's taken way too long to get my Rex available here. That's one thing I haven't figured out. I haven't learned yet if the wrecks are earned by like the number of kills you're getting or if it's time based. Generally don't like stuff where it's kill based because if you're having a lousy game, it's just gonna stay lousy. Ugh. Tired of all these hits I'm taking, man. My weapons are sucky, and I'm just kind of making bad decisions, and yeah, it's not going my way here. I don't really have a great weapon for sniping. I think I better just get into the mix and hope that I can get some kills here. I feel like they're shooting me from so freaking far away, too. I can't get close enough to them. Oh, come on. Do you see that? Whole wave of them just warped in right next to me there.
Remain.
I don't like any of these weapons, really. I will take a Warthog, though. I am really over just using the pistol and the assault rifle right now. I would love access to an unlimited ammo chain gun, so I'm gonna use this. Oh boy, I'm gonna get shot out of this thing. I just know it. Yeah, there it goes.
1 minute left.
I'm under fire. Taking fire from a soldier. Crawler's targeting me.
This loss is unacceptable.
Oh wow, yeah, I'm jumping right into the bad things right here.
30 seconds
Maybe I can
left.
Go find my warthog. Is that back here? This kind of looks like where I was shooting from. Maybe not. 30 seconds left. We haven't killed either boss. Yeah, this one's over. This was a pretty brutal run for us here. This, I must not have been the only one having a tough time.
Objective failed.
Well, it's all right. When that happens, you load up, you give it another go. Or if it's late, you pack it in for the night, but it's not that late yet, so I'm just gonna keep going. What, we get a crushing defeat rec pack to open here? No? Okay. Okay. All right, so what I would like to see is one where we go up against the Eternal Wardens, because those are always fun. Those are tough fights, and hopefully it's not the urban map. The urban map, they get tucked away in an area where it's hard to get your vehicles. There's another one that's kind of like the one we were just on. And that one's a lot easier to get your vehicles out. Any place where you can use the heavy vehicles, like the tanks or the Mantis mechs, it makes it so much easier to win these things.
Suit up, Spartans. This is Warzone Firefight. You're the last boots on the ground. Fight through rounds of increasing difficulty.
All right.
Round one.
So this is not the map that I had mentioned. This one's tough too, actually. I played this with my friend John fairly recently. And the bosses kind of spawned in a room sort of like this one, but it was all walled off, and it was hard to get to. It was hard to get in there, even on foot. We were having a hard time figuring out how to make it happen. I think he got a tank right during the final wave, and I had a warthog, and neither of us could find our way in. Uh-oh. Bail. Heard a grenade.
We got a man down.
Drag one.
These doorways. Absolutely deadly with everybody packed in there like that. Stopping each other from getting out.
Recharged and ready.
Protect yourself.
Okay, so clearly they're above us. Wasn't trying to shoot my teammate there. Friendly fire's off anyway, but Yeah, that was tight. I always check, and I don't know why. I always check in that first round. What wrecks do I have? Do I have new wrecks? No, you don't. You'll use your assault rifle and pistol, and you'll like it.
Night Marshal takedown. Round complete. Level 2 wrecks available.
Recharged and ready. What is a level 2 wreck anyway? I don't even know. It's probably some garbage weapon like the plasma pistol.
Took a scatter shot.
I want a faster way to unlock all of the stronger wrecks. Don't get me wrong, I love this mode. Sometimes you just want to play the entire thing with a sniper rifle if you can, you know? Now this is cool, actually. The Covenant and the Prometheans sharing tech. So you get enemies that are like a mix. That's really cool, and I love the stages where you'll see both sometimes. Shooting at a shadow. Hit it. Okay, yeah, that's not good. Controller disconnecting. I don't know what happened there. Last I checked, my battery was doing just fine. But I guess I'm going to take a moment to plug it in here just to play it safe. So bear with me here. Also means I gotta change up where I'm sitting too, because
complete. Level 3 wrecks available.
There we go. All right, hopefully no more of that. Let's get back into it here. Good thing this wasn't anything important or anything, you know. Good thing I wasn't, like, you know, live streaming or. I suppose at least I didn't have like money riding on this or something, right? Imagine if this was like Street Fighter V or something like that, Killer Instinct, and you like got something real riding on the line. I've never actually bet anything on a video game before. Now that I think about it, if I'm gonna be honest about it. Yep, okay, I get it. He's still shooting the crap out of me as I'm already dead. Any more rare random weapons? No? Okay. I gotta go up another level or two in wrecks, and then I can get access to them, apparently. Can I jump up here? Yes. Huh. Where's the fight? Okay, there we go. I saw some blips on my radar there. They're all over my radar. I don't see any, though. Super odd. There we go. Okay, there's some enemies. There's some action. Supposed to be killing crawlers right now. Here I am messing with these knights.
Two minutes remain.
There we go. Now find a rec station so I can get ammo. There we go. But we still got a lot of crawlers to go and only a minute and a half to do it in. Where the heck are they? They gotta be like underground or something. Yeah, here we go, right? This has to lead me somewhere. I don't think we're gonna make it in a minute here. I don't think my teammates really know about this. There we go, now I got another guy down here. Seconds, we're not gonna make it.
10 seconds. Only a couple targets left.
Oh, if only I had a grenade.
Objective failed.
Well, forgive me for sounding like a whiner here, but that seemed a little unfair just because we couldn't find the dang enemies. Alright, so we'll load up another match here. Can't go out like that. Gotta go out on a high note, of course. And why don't I go ahead and see if I can buy a silver rec pack here. Costs 5,000 rec points. I've got 9,613. Worth it. I'll do it. I usually wait for gold ones, but I just thought maybe since I've been having a tough go of it, we could always use some more cards, even if they're lower level ones. Why not? All right, that's all good. I wonder if I can knock this one out quick before the match starts. Do we have time for one more? Yes, all right, we got our last pack spent, so good. Okay, I'm going in with as much stuff as I can, at least. I've got that going for me. I would love it if this would be that map where the water is being held back by the barriers. Oh, I think it is. Yes, this is my favorite map. It's so cool. I really like the design of the energy barrier holding back the water around this spot. Super cool. I think this might be the map that I've spent the most time on, too, actually. This is,
Round one.
Coincidentally, my favorite.
Defend the armory, Spartan.
Got him. Alright. Oh! Let's duck out of there quick. Taking some damage. Oh! I think my teammates got wiped in there when I was falling back in, thinking it was safe territory, but oh well. I thought that went pretty well for the most part. I was getting a good number of kills. Man, it's just endless grenades out here. Yeah, I guess not. Well, yeah, there's another one. Jeez. I'm going in from the top. This is for the birds down here. Oh, missed it. So hard to make that jump sometimes. Let's just see if I can push past. Anything good worth picking up? Nope. Nice. That was a decent little streak. Let's get some ammo. I don't like not having a weapon that I can snipe with. Uh-oh. There we go. I heard a grenade, and he's like, "Grenade coming in." I didn't know where it was. I was like, "Oh, that's not going to be good."
Left.
Fire from the front.
guys. Walk right into that, please. Oh, gosh. Get back behind some cover.
Enemy going loud.
Level 3 racks available.
Enemy down.
10 seconds.
Nice one.
Got a jackal on me. Return fire.
Enemy
rebel target. Damn it. You're
a
hero.
Ah.
Base defended. Round complete.
Oh, hey. I can now equip this. So that's good. What do we got here? There's no, I find it strange that there's no thing for sniper rifles here. Like, there should be a dedicated one for sniper rifles.
Round two.
Oh, it's down lower. Idiot.
Respawn timer increased.
Oh my god. I'm so dumb.
Protect the forerunner core, Spartans.
Of course it's down here.
Hostiles are damaging the target.
Well, that's embarrassing. And all the time I've been playing this, I've not ever burned a sniper. I guess that's the upside. I had to have a bunch of them stored up now from never having used one. And now that I know where they are, I can start using them. Oh, whoa, whoa, look at that behind me. Wow. That's insane. That all just spawned right behind me there. That hardly seems fair.
Target at 75%.
Saw a grenade come sailing over here. Let's see if we threw it though.
Solid kill.
Man, I have no idea where I even got killed from. It's just madness over there right now. You know what? I'm gonna use a saw. I like the saw. It's exactly what you need for a situation like this. Oh, come on. Seriously? Well, at least I had my saw, right? It's too bad I had to use half of it before I even got up here. All right, good. Got it.
Round complete.
Seriously?
Level 5 recs available.
Well, not really too much punishment there. I'm going to go with a random vehicle. Either uncommon or rare, huh? I think I'll go... maybe I'll just wait. I'll wait. We'll see. We'll see what's coming. This map is perfect for vehicles, though. This is my favorite map, actually. And it's because it's so friendly to vehicles. Hunters. Yeah, this is vehicle territory here. Just one volley of shots from those guys just gets your shield down so far. Yeah, I'm gonna go get a rec pack because I'm gonna just get picked off here. Oh hey, yeah, Wraith or yeah, I can do random. Cool. Yes, perfect. This is perfect. Oh crap, no. Not perfect, spawning right next to ships. Oh, not good spawning right on top of the enemy. Let's try to get out of here. Holy crap. Okay. I survived. Try to get out of there. Maybe change up my tactics to just doing bombing runs here. I like doing bombing runs in the Banshees. It's definitely fun. I like kind of staying above the fray. Oh, let's get out of here. Took too much damage there.
Level 6 wrecks available. Teammates eliminated a serpent hunter.
Nice.
Round complete.
Good job, everybody.
Level 7 wrecks available. Round 4. Protect those Forerunner cores, Spartans.
Protection wave, huh? These are always tough. Love it if I could take that thing down. Nope, just disappears. I wonder if it's even possible. I guess maybe with a Spartan laser you could do it. I'm just taking a wild guess, though. I'm not certain at all about that. I don't like any of the weapons I've got access to. Or the vehicles, rather. But I wanted to have a sniper rifle. I bet I got a bunch of cards here. 16 of them. And one rare one. Let's go with the rare one. That's too tempting to pass up right now. Let's see if we can get to a high point. And my first shot is a big ol' miss. Good job. Get on top of this building here. I bet that'd be my ideal vantage point.
One target left, Spartans. Protect it. Hostiles are damaging the target.
Oh yeah, I feel like I can see that thing ticking down. Too slow. You suck, Uno. Oh my gosh. How many times can I miss? This is a crappy vantage point, really. Are they going to drop right next to me here? Because that'd be cool if I had a spot where I could actually hit them from. Wow. Took a lot of shots. There we go. Made my last one count.
2 minutes remain. Targeted 50%.
I'm almost to a rare vehicle. I'm gonna hang in there and wait for that.
Targeted 25%.
Oh wow. I feel like I better get over there.
Target destruction imminent.
Ah, crap.
Objective failed.
I should have gotten a heavier weapon and just got my butt over here. Been more of a help to the team than sitting back there missing with the sniper rifle, but what are you going to do? I'm going to give this one more go. I can't go out like that. Got to go out on a high note. I can afford a cheapy rec pack here. Two of them, actually, so I'm gonna do it. Ooh, Tundra Warthog. Reminds me of home. All right, so it'll get us hooked up with one more here. We had every reason to win that last one. It was the great outdoors map. We had a guy in a mantis, for crying out loud. We probably should have won that one, but can't win them all, I guess. Urban is a tough one, or it can be, because this is another one where the enemies can spawn back in an area where you can't get your vehicles. You can't get your tanks or your wraiths really back there, or your banshees, or anything really, because there's an elevated spot, but there's no staircase to get up there. You have to jump to reach it, and so none of the vehicles will make it. Before, we just lost two in a row without great reason. I would have said that the only reason to lose at all is on maps like this one, when you can't get your vehicles back by the bosses, but now I've seen otherwise.
Suit up, Spartans. This is Warzone Firefight. You're the last boots on the ground. Fight through rounds of increasing difficulty.
All right, we're dropping in via pod.
Round one. Incoming Covenant threat. Focus on those Covenant hostiles.
Yeah, he's got the same idea as me. Bet probably everybody starts this one out this way. Stairs make for a nice vantage point. Again. Checking. Do I have anything? No. It's just like a reflex at this point. I'm like, damn it, I want that grunt. It's already dead though. Taking some really nasty hits there. Man, these guys never run out of freaking grenades apparently. Nice. Is there a sword around here? I feel like I walked over a sword a minute ago.
Level 3 recs available.
Nope, no swords. Long shot assault rifle. I'll take that. Hey, not too bad. Oh, snazzy. Got some range. Right on.
Round 2. Respawn timer increased. Incoming Promethean threat.
Oh, 1 second. I gotta hide in here for just a moment. Just long enough to let my dog outside.
Promethean threat materializing.
Now I know better than to test my dog when he rings the bell to go outside. I'd rather pause for a second than have to clean up pee. One down. I really want that knight down. Yeah, okay. Alright, I'll go get some more ammo. Nice.
From a soldier.
Round complete.
Nice. That was all me.
Level 5 recs available.
Thanks to this guy's awesome long shot assault rifle. This thing's amazing. Shield back up.
Threat confirmed. Round three.
Alright. I got two awesome starting weapons.
Eliminate all threats.
Things are looking up. Definitely looking up from that last game. Everybody's making pretty short work of these crawlers. That's going real well. Uh-oh. Oh, I'm getting surrounded here. It's all on my radar. Oh, wow. They're all up here. Yeah, no, I don't want to die. I need this long shot rifle. Oh, crap. Ah! That weapon was amazing. I want that thing back. I want that back so bad. What do I have access to here? Rocket launcher. Two additional in each shot. Yeah, that sounds amazing. Yeah, let's go with this one.
Threat confirmed.
Yeah, baby. Three for the price of one with every shot. Now we're talking. Didn't realize those things were in the air, though. I would have grabbed my other one that had the tracking upgrade on it. Smart upgrade, rather. Crap. Damn it! death comes so quick, man. I had such a good weapon there, too. Ah, what a bummer. Maybe it's still laying there. Maybe. Oh god, please let it still be there. Yes! Alright! We just need to kill Prometheans right now. I don't know why I'm obsessing over those stupid Phaetons. I guess it's because I got a rocket launcher and I really want to hit them with it. Rude. Out of rockets. Oh, wow. Look at this guy warping right up into my face. Can we kill Prometheans here? In enough time, I wonder. Yep, I'm in. Maybe if I clear the skies a little bit, teammates will be able to get out from cover.
Ah,
man. That is rough. I don't know if we're going to do it. We have not much time to kill like 20 of them.
If
I can even just get like one headshot here. 10 seconds. Ah, boy. I don't know. I don't think we can do it. Nope. Objective oh, that's crap. That's crap. I'm not going out like that. I got this. This broadcast resumes until I go out on a high note. Damn it. All right. Excuse me for 1 second. I'm gonna go let the dogs in. All right. Pardon me again. Dogs have to pee. Life resumes while you're broadcasting. Not a bad haul here. I don't use Arena XP. May as well sell that stuff. Okay. Now, this will be the game. We're going to get through all five waves. And I'm going to do real impressive stuff. You're going to see all kinds of 360 ladder no scopes. yeah, prepare to be amazed. I don't know if you can hear that in the background, if that's making it through the mic, but that is my dogs just going berserk on each other. All kinds of dog wrestling going on in here tonight.
Suit up, Spartans. This is Warzone Firefight.
All right, we can do this.
You're the last boots on the ground.
I'm even standing up for this one. Standing right in front of my TV, like I'm at the arcade, rather. Whoa! Check out the Rainbow Coalition dude right there.
Incoming Covenant threat.
Get another look at that guy's armor. That's fantastic! Look at that. And then his weapon is all rainbow colored too. Okay, time to focus. Sorry. I was mesmerized momentarily by your weaponry and your armor.
Elite's on me.
Covenant are running from us, basically. That's what that looks like to me. Almost went down there. No grenades. I got some pistol ammo.
Enemy
takedown. Round complete. Level 3 recs available.
Okay, time to go get some ammo. That wasn't a bad round. I didn't die, did I? I don't think I died. If I died, I forgot about it already. I don't think I did, though.
Round 2. Respawn timer increased. Elites are our primary target. Wreck confirmed.
I think I'll go pick up that sword over there, because that sounds like fun. I want to run right up to that pack of elites with the sword here, but I don't think I'd survive it. Especially with the ship right there. Dang it! Stupid jackal. I'm just gonna rush these fools. Well, it kind of backfired. Not my best plan. It was what I wanted to do, though, and I stand by it.
Targets eliminated. Round complete. Level 4 recs available.
Level 4 recs. That's still not enough for anything that amazing, so I guess I'm going to probably wait. Man, I wish I had that guy's long-range assault rifle, though. That thing was awesome.
Round 3.
I need that back.
Incoming Prometheans. Red confirmed.
Yeah, I'll go with that. Sounds good. Warden Eternal already on round 3? That's usually a round 5 boss. Down and back up. Oh man, this is a meat grinder in here. This is probably dumb, but I'm gonna do it. Yep, that was dumb. Especially since I turned my back on the Warden Eternal. That was certain death. What do I have? Do I have anything? Yeah, let's take a fuel rod.
Wreck confirmed.
I'll get some good mileage out of a fuel rod cannon, I think. As long as I don't get killed along the way trying to get there. Tired of these guys warping around everywhere. Really hard to keep track of where they're going. Dogs are getting bucked wild in the background. Nice. We did it.
Level 6 wrecks available.
I'm interested to go listen to this later and see if I can hear those two in the background. Like I said, folks, buck wild.
Round 4. Wreck confirmed. Incoming Covenant threat. Grunt mech near your position.
Oh, sweet. I love fighting the grunt mechs. But I know I'm going to probably want a vehicle or some kind of better weapon for that. Oh, yeah. A goshawk. Yeah, okay. Let's do it. Hopefully I can find a spot to park this baby where it's safe, and then I can just rain death. More likely what'll happen is I will get shot down by a dropship. So he already knows I'm here. Have all day to dork around with this too. Look at that. Hey, that'll work. Called it, of course. Freaking drop ship. Oh, come on. Give the guy a break. Seriously. All I want to do is use my Gauss cannon. Really tired of having them rain death on me. Really tired of it. Wanted to get a little bit of vengeance, but no, too much to ask. I'm not gonna let this thing get chewed up by grunts. Hey, my spot from earlier. This'll work, right? Do I have an angle? I got an angle.
Shields up.
Had an angle.
2 minutes remain.
Come on out from your cover.
Teammates are falling to the Covenant.
Wasn't doing as much damage as I'd kind of hoped anyway, but still, it's disappointing getting knocked out of it like that. I don't think I want to bother with any other vehicles right now. I want to try and make it back to that one. Hopefully it's still there. That'd be great. There it is. Oh, come on! It's like the game just gave me a wave and then the middle finger.
One minute left.
We can take him out in a minute, can't we? I think so.
Round complete. Level 7 recs available.
Okay, level 7 recs. Let's go see what I can get. Get a rare vehicle. I think I'll go with that. Otherwise, there's the Halo 2 sniper. Or beam sniper. No, I'm gonna go with the vehicle.
Protect that target, Spartan.
And hope it's a good one.
Red confirmed.
Hey, alright, I'll take it. Right back to that ridge. Oh no 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 no. Oh, come on. See, I thought maybe I would just plow through those hunters. I thought maybe I had a shot at just kind of not killing them in one hit with the car, but just, you know, I don't know, doing some good damage and then driving by, and it just... No.
Wreck confirmed.
No, it's not at all what happened. You know what, though? A ghost might be okay for just doing defense in that area. It's quick. I can lay down a bunch of fire. Good for wiping out ground forces, and then we've got some wraiths and tanks for the heavier stuff out here already. I was so excited to have that rocket warthog. Oh well. Can I paste all these guys? Awesome. Guess what the dogs are doing right now? They're just laying there. They're finally all petered out. They're kind of reverse spooning, though. They're back to back. It's adorable. That'd make a better video than me dying repeatedly with my awesome rocket warthog. I'd say this is going pretty well. These things have what? I guess that one's got all of its health. That one's got nearly all of it. I'd say they don't really have much hope at taking us out in a minute and a half here. More hunters. That's fine. Between our rates and tanks and all that stuff that we've got out here, these guys are gonna go down quick. Woo! Minute left. Level 9 wrecks. It's almost worth getting out of this thing and going and buying a new wreck, but I won't. We're kicking so much ass here, it'd just be a waste to go summon a mantis or something like that right now. I wish this mode had a way to access all of the top level wrecks immediately if you wanted to. I wish you didn't have to sit and wait for it to finally escalate in the final round. Because it happens more often than not that I don't get access to level 8 or 9 wrecks until there's like a minute left in the game. And when you only get to pilot a mantis for like a minute, it kind of feels like you just want to hang on to the cards for some other time that I guess will never actually come, where you think like, oh, I'll get to drive it longer if I just wait, but not really.
All rounds clear, Spartan. Simulation complete.
All right, so we're going out on a high note. Not my best match. Totally broke my heart when I lost that Rocket Warthog, but you know, a victory's a victory. I'll take it. Anyway, that is Halo 5 Warzone Firefight. Check it out sometime. Hopefully, if you do, you dig it as much as I do. I think this is the best thing to come to Halo in some time. I really am excited to see what the next version of this looks like in Halo 6 when that comes out in, you know, 2 or 3 years, whenever it may be. I think they have a real good thing going here. But anyway, thanks again, everybody, and we'll catch you next time.